All right, everyone, we're here with Jeremy with two Eco-Deltas here in the shop. We've got two because we have two different sort of battery mounting schemes. On the right, we have a black hard case aluminum battery. This is a 10 amp hour, 36 volt battery. We like to do 36 volt on this bike to keep the speed a little lower, to keep us down at 20 miles an hour instead of up at 26 miles an hour. So use 36 volt. And we have a special mounting for these batteries. You see that we've got some hardware here in the back, some L-brackets, some spacers, and some screws. And that allows us to mount this battery plate directly onto the frame on these seat strut ears without drilling any holes in anything. Mounts right on. So that hardware, when we're doing it in the shop, it looks a bit like this. Got L-brackets, we got spacers, we got screws. And if we look a second time, now that you see, we've got two spacers up front to keep the seat struts wide of the battery itself, and one spacer in the back. And this just lines up the L-brackets so everything fits nicely. And this would be a great finished way to mount the battery at home or in the shop. And so again, this is the hardware that we're using. It's a couple of either quarter 20 or M6 screws, some long ones and some short ones, and some small nylon spacers, and some regular fender L-brackets. So we stock this hardware here in small quantities. We can sell it, but you can also get it from a lot of other sources. Now, when we're using a soft pack blue battery in a trunk bag, we kind of do the same thing. So Jeremy's got a bag here, and he's pulling it off the bike for us. Now, we start off with the same kind of mount, but we use a larger plate. We use this 48 volt plate that's a bit longer, you'll see, than the other plate. And that gives us enough space to cut slots into the plate in order to run the Velcro straps for the bag. And so what we do here is we just take a bag or we have a template and we mark out a line, drill five holes, and then connect the holes with a hand file. We've also used a jigsaw in the past. You may have some other tools that you can use for this. And that lets us again mount the battery directly to the frame. So all the hardware is the same, but we use a 48 volt, an extra long plate, even though we're using a 36 volt battery. And then we can mount the bag to it. It gives us a nice finished look there. There is a slightly easier option for mounting the battery if you don't want to get the extra hardware and go through the trouble. This can be a little bit easier, but it doesn't look quite right. We've got two options. Jeremy's got a rear recumbent basket from JMB there. These guys mount onto the rear of your seat and they sit up a little bit higher on the bike. And you can put like the 9 amp hour soft pack battery in there in its bag. And that's a good option. This basket can really hold probably about 5 pounds, and the 9 amp hour battery is about 4.5 pounds. So that would be one way to mount the battery, is to use the rear recumbent basket from JMB. Another possibility is to use a regular rear rack, either our two-tiered rack, or we have an Axiom Journey there as well, and use extra long rack struts. This is a little bit strange, but it'll make sense when you look on the bike. These racks will actually fit onto the rear seat ears of the bike, just barely into the rear seat ears. So you can attach this, and then you can attach these extra long rack struts down to the front seat ears. And so when you've got that all set up, you've got a regular rear bike rack sticking out of the back of the bike. It looks a little goofy, but it is one way to mount these batteries without having to use L brackets and spacers. You just use a regular rear bike rack with some extra long struts, and then you get a fairly finished looking battery mount. There's one other special piece of hardware that's really important, which is the torque arm. On this bike, we always use two torque arms, and you have to remember to use the C washers as well. The reason for using two torque arms is because these forks seem to be a little softer than most that we deal with, and if everything is not just right on this bike, the wheel can come out. So you'll see, in order to give us some extra safety in case the axle nuts don't get tightened properly or the sea washers are not in all the way, the two torque arms make sure that that wheel will always stay put. So the torque arm will actually slip over the plug coming out of the axle. Looks like it doesn't fit, but it'll fit just fine. And then you can put one on either side and you have a lot of security. You'll see this is not the most beefy fork, so an extra bit of security makes sure that wheel never comes out. Lastly, the pedal assist with this bike. In a normal e-bike kit, you're going to get the quick zip tie pedal assist setup with the adhesive back. There's a separate video on installing this. It's very straightforward. On this bike, you're going to want an extension cable in order to extend the wire so that it'll reach all the way to the front. And when you're installing it, you'll see that it can be a little tricky on this bike because there's no seat tube. You've got to mount this pedal assist onto the boom tube here, and there's really not a lot of room on the boom tube to mount it, so you got to get creative with your zip ties when you're securing the pedal assist. Instead of doing that, when we're doing it in the shop, we choose to do it a different way. We mount a ring type pedal assist sensor down under the bottom bracket. This means drilling and tapping a hole into the bottom bracket for the direct mounting though. And we can send you instructions on doing that as well. That bracket that we use is this right angle ring type bracket. So this is a modified version of our regular TDH sensor ring bracket that's got a right angle 90 degree in it so that we can mount it directly to the frame. The reason for this is this bottom bracket spindle length doesn't give us enough room to mount inside of the right hand bottom bracket cup. There's just no space. So we've got to mount it directly to the frame so that we can adjust it left and right to get everything lined up. So we have an instruction sheet on that if you'd like to try that for a little more secure mounting than the left hand mounting. We can send that information over to you. Next, we run all of the cables and everything. The screen goes right in the center of the handlebars where it looks really well suited, just pops right into that crossbar. The cables tuck in nice and tight under the handlebars. They go down under the boom tube, below the bottom bracket, all the way to the back of the frame. And again, this is the normal cable length, except for the pedal assist where you'll need an extension cable. This is the normal cable length. Everything fits just fine on this bike. And then the controller we've got mounted directly to the seat frame, screwed right in with some controller clamps. And when you're all done, you end up with a bike that looks just like it should have any bike kit system on it, and everything fits very well. Thanks for watching. If you need detailed instructions on this, we have some instruction sheets. Let us know if we can help.